Hello friends, welcome to National PC YouTube channel, myself Prosenjit. Today I am really excited to present you one of the flagship product from Intel, Intel NUC 13 Extreme Kit. This is really extreme kit because this product has many more features. In this video, I will tell you all the technical specification about this product. I will also show you how to install all the components in this extreme kit. So let's begin this video. Intel NUC 13 Extreme Kit. This product is available with Intel 13th generation processor with i5, i7 and i9. This particular device is Intel NUC 13 1390K processor, which is i9 processor. This Extreme Kit has many more features. I will tell you one by one. First of all, this product has 13th generation processor. This product supports the DDR5 RAM up to 64GB and it also supports the 4800MHz. This device has two LAN ports, one is 10 Gbps and one is 2.5 Gbps. Both are super fast. Also, this device has the latest Wi-Fi 6E and the Bluetooth 5.3, which is also the latest generation of all the networking configuration. Now, if we talk about the storage, this particular Extreme Kit can support the 3M.2, which is generation 4. Also, this mini PC or this Extreme Kit can support 4 SSD. This 4 SSD means you can install the 2.5 inch SSD or 2.5 inch hard disk. The SATA hard disk, it can support up to 4. This device has, if we talk about the display purpose, this device has the two Thunderbolt 4 port, which is the nearby 40 Gbps of bandwidth. Also, this device has HDMI port, which is HDMI 2.1. If we talk about this mini PC other features, this particular PC has 8 USB 3.0 type A ports, one is USB 3.2 type C port. This device has the major advantage. This device can support internal dedicated graphics card. This dedicated graphics card can be 12 inch long and it can support the 3 slot graphics card, which is the latest one. This device has the inbuilt power supply, which is 750 watt gold power supply. This 755 watt gold power supply also has the ATX 5.0. that means this particular Extreme Kit can support the RTX 4000 series, which is the latest one, because RTX 4000 series needs the ATX 5.0 power supply. So let's unpack this particular Extreme Kit and I will show you all the technical specification. I will show you all the ports. I will also show you how to install the components. Intel NUC 13 Extreme Kit, very big package. Let's cut the seal. This one for the SATA power and SATA data cable. This one the Wi-Fi antenna. This one is the GPU holder. These are manuals. Wow, very slim design. It's near about 1 feet few inches. Let's check all the sides. This side has the all ports and this is clearly seen the SMPS power cord position, and this is the power on off switch. This is the top panel, this is the front panel, and everywhere there is ventilation. And this ventilation also have the mesh facility, so there is no direct dust will be there. So this is actually very good design. All side there is ventilation. first check from the top side. Top side, this is the power button, and there is also have the LED. So when the power will be on, the LED will be go on. This is the two USB 3.2 generation 2 port. This is also the type C port. This is type C port, also the USB 3.2 generation 2. This is the headphone and microphone jack. Let's check the backside, all panel and all ports. These two are for the Wi-Fi 6E antenna. This one for the normal the 6.1 audio. This one is the HDMI port. This HDMI port is HDMI 2.1 port. And these two are for the LAN port. This LAN port is the small written is there. This is the 10 Gbps LAN port, and this is the 2.5 Gbps of LAN port. This 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, this 6 blue color USB type A port. This is the USB 3.2 generation 2 port. And these two ports, the type C, but this port, the internally, the specification is Thunderbolt 4. This two port can support 40 Gbps of total bandwidth. Also, it support the display. This display is DP 2.1, the DP 1.4. And this is the power on-off button. So let's open this Extreme Kit, and I will show you the internal specification. I will show you how to install the SSD. Also, I will show you how to install the dedicated graphics card. So let's open this. To open this, first we have to open this top panel. After that, this is the front side. This is the back side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These are the old screw. We have to open this first. Open this, simply pull it upside. This is the two RAM slot. This is the SODIMM slot. This can support up to 64 GB. That means 32 plus 32. Right now we have the 16 plus 16. 2 DDR5 4800 MHz RAM, and this section is for the graphics card. Right now we have the normal 2 fan graphics card, the standard size for, and this card has the 2 slot. This position space is very minimum, so first we have to choose the power cord for the GPU, then we will install this GPU power cable first, then we have to install this GPU here. If we check all the power cable, this is for the graphics card, this is also for the graphics card. This one is specifically for the ATX 5.0, this 300 watt. This is for the RTX new generation, this particular port. This is not required for us, we have the RTX second generation card. And this particular card has the 8 plus 6. This is the 8 plus 6. Simply push it. So graphics card installation is done. Now we have to install the SSDs. For this particular SSD install, we have to install the 3 M.2 SSD. Here is on lock. Just open this lock and we have to pull out this position. Then we have to pull the right side and we have to open this. Here is the section for 3 SSD. You can use the generation 4 SSD. If we use the SATA SSD, we have to use this one. This is for the SATA power. This is the SATA data cable. This one also SATA data cable. To install the SATA SSD, this is the SATA power. You have to install the SATA power in this position, just like this. And you have to install this once again. So we have installed the SSD. This is the two ports, one is the big one, one is the small one. You have to just
push it on the downside.
We have connected all the power cable and HDMI cable with this monitor. Let's power up this device. So this particular device has the Core i9-13900K, and this particular processor can boost up to 5.8 GHz, which is a very good speed. And you can check, this is the total memory of 16+16, 4800 MHz, that means it is a DDR5 RAM. If we check the advanced section, it has the onboard device. You can control from here, USB, PCI Express, video control, the video device or video graphics, you can control from here. If you use the internal GPU, you can set the maximum memory for the allocated internal graphics card from this position. We check for the cooling section. Cooling section, you can adjust the CPU fan control as the balanced mode or the cool mode or the quiet mode, you can choose from this position. So from BIOS, you can check all the details, and you can also configure its hyper threading and turbo boost. Everything you can control from this BIOS section. The particular device, the benchmark and everything will be covered in this description sections. You can check all the benchmark in the description. We have provided you all the links and everything. So for this particular device, you can use any kind of purpose. If you need in the office or your personal or gaming purpose or video editing purpose. So I will suggest you to use this particular Extreme Kit if you need one ITX build or small form factor build for your working purpose. Intel NUC13 Extreme Kit. I hope you have liked all the technical details and all the technical features. You can use this particular device any kind of production purpose, your video editing purpose, or any kind of powerful gaming purpose. Because this device has the inbuilt 750 volt good power supply. Also, this has the dedicated graphics card slot, which is PCIe Generation 5. That means you can use the extreme graphics card with this particular product. If you like this video, please share as much as possible. Also, subscribe our National PC YouTube channel to get the latest update of the new products. I will see you on the next video.